Now we are going to see exercise 4.2, problem number 1. In a triangle ABC, D and E are the points of the sides AB and AC respectively, such that D is parallel to BC. So first subdivision, if AD by DB is equal to 3 by 4 and AC is equal to 15 cm, then find AE. And second subdivision is, if AD is equal to 8x minus 7, DB is equal to 5x minus 3, AE is equal to 4x minus 3 and EC is equal to 3x minus 1, then find the value of x. Exercise 4.2. First one, first subdivision solution. This is the given measurement. So here we can see ABC is a triangle and D is a point on the side AB and AC. Now AD is 3 cm. DB is 4 cm and A to C is 15 cm. So given that AD by DB is equal to 3 by 4, AC is equal to 15 cm. So from that we can find EC is equal to AC minus AE, which is equal to 15 minus AE. By using basic proportionality theorem, we have AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Now substitute the values here. 3 by 4 is equal to AE divided by EC is nothing but 15 minus AE. The next step is cross multiplication. So 3 into 15 minus AE is equal to 4AE. 3 into 15 is 45. 45 minus 3AE is equal to 4AE. So 45 is equal to 4AE plus 3AE. 4 plus 3 is 7AE is equal to 45. So AE is equal to 45 by 7. The value of AE is equal to 6.43 cm. First problem, second subdivision. This is the respective measurement. So AD is given as 8x minus 7 and DB is 5x minus 3. AE is 4x minus 3 and E to C is 3x minus 1. You have to find the value of x. So by basic proportionality theorem, we know that AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. So here you just write the given measurement. AD is equal to 8x minus 7, DB is equal to 5x minus 3, AE is equal to 4x minus 3, EC is equal to 3x minus 1. So substitute the values in the basic proportionality theorem, that is AD by DB is equal to AE by AC. So substitute the values, then the next step is cross multiplication. So 3x minus 1 into 8x minus 7 and 4x minus 3 into 5x minus 3. Next step is you have to do the multiplication. So 8x into 3x is 24x square. Then minus 7 into 3x is minus 21x. Minus 8x into minus 1 is minus 8x. Then minus 7 into minus 1 is plus 7. So similarly, we have to do the multiplication, which is equal to 4x into 5x is 20x square. Then minus 3 into 5x is minus 15x. Then 4x into minus 3 is minus 12x. And minus into minus plus 3, 3 is a 9. So the next step is you have to take all this to your left hand side, which is equal to 0. So 24x square minus 20x square, then 24x square minus 20x square. Then here you have 21x and minus 8x, then minus 15x minus 12x. If you add this two, you get minus 27. So if you are taking to your left hand side, it will become plus 27x. Then plus 7 minus 9 is equal to 0. Then you get 4x square minus 2x minus 2 is equal to 0. Throughout divided by 2, you get 2x square minus x minus 1 is equal to 0. Then you get a quadratic equation. Then you have to split the factors. So 2x square minus 2x plus x minus 1 is equal to 0. In this, we can see 2x is common. So taking 2x is common out, remaining is x minus 1 plus 1 into x minus 1 is equal to 0. So equating the factors to 0, you get x is equal to 1 and x is equal to minus 1 by 2. So we can see x cannot be negative. So the value of x is equal to 1. Next problem number 2 in exercise 4.2. ABCD is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to DC and P and Q are the points on AB and BC respectively, such that PQ is parallel to DC if PD is equal to 18 cm, BQ is equal to 35 cm and QC is equal to 15 cm. Find the value of AD. So problem number 2 solution. You can see a trapezium AB, CD. So idla vandu PD oda measurement nammal kuduthirukanga. So that is PD is 18 cm and CQ is 15 cm. Then BQ or QB is equal to 35 cm. Then join the line from A to C. It meets PQ at the point G. Now we can see a triangle. Now we can see two triangles. One triangle is ADC and another one triangle is ACB. So join AC such that it meets PQ at G. We can see AB is parallel to DC. So in the line AB yum DC yum parallel a irukum. Similarly and PQ, we can see PQ is parallel to DC, then PQ is parallel to AB. First we are taking a triangle ADC. So first we are taking the triangle ADC. In this PG is parallel to DC. Inga PG yum DC in the rendu line parallel a irukku nammalku. So AP by PD is equal to AG by GC. That's your equation number 1. Similarly for taking the triangle CAB or ABC, you can write AG by GC is equal to BQ by QC. This is your equation number 2. So from 1 and 2 we can write AP by PD is equal to இங்கேயும் ஏஜி பை ஜிசி இருக்குது, இங்கேயும் ஏஜி பை ஜிசி இருக்குது. ஸோ இது ரெண்டுத்தையும் டேரெக்டாக நம்ம ஈக்குவேட் பண்ணிக்கலாம். ஏபி பை பிடி இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு பிக்யூ பை கியூசி. நவ் யூ ஜஸ்ட் சப்ஸ்டியூட் த வேல்யூஸ். ஏபி இஸ் டிவைடட் பை 18 இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 35 டிவைடட் பை 15. ஸோ ஏபி இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 35 இன்டூ 18 பை 15. ஸோ த வேல்யூ ஆஃப் ஏபி இஸ் 42 சென்டிமீட்டர். பட் யூ ஹேவ் டு ஃபைண்ட் த வேல்யூ ஆஃப் ஏடி. ஏடி இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஏபி பிளஸ் பிடி, which is equal to 42 plus 18. Therefore, the value of AD is equal to 60 cm. Problem number 3. In a triangle ABC, D and E are the points of the sides AB and AC respectively. For each of the following cases, show that DE is parallel to BC. First subdivision, AB is equal to 12 cm, AD is equal to 8 cm, AE is equal to 12 cm and AC is equal to 18 cm. So problem number 3, first subdivision, this is the given measurement, AB is equal to 12 cm, AD is equal to 8 cm, AE is also 12 and AC is 18 cm. So according to the measurement, we draw the diagram here. So here AB is 12, AD is 8. Then AC is 18 and AE is 12. By using basic proportionality theorem, we can write AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Now you can substitute the values. First we are taking AD by DB. So AD by DB is equal to AD value is 8 and DB is nothing but AB minus AD. So which is equal to 8 divided by 12 minus 8. So which is equal to 8 by 4 is equal to 2. So AD by DB is 2. Now we are taking AE by EC. So AE by EC is equal to 12 divided by same method. So EC is nothing but AC minus AE. So 12 divided by 18 minus 12, which is equal to 12 by 6 is equal to 2. This is your equation number 2. So from 1 and 2 we can see it is clear that AD by DB and AE by EC both are equal. Therefore DE is parallel to BC. So similarly we can do the third problem, second subdivision. That's your homework problem. So the given measurement is AB is equal to 5.6 cm, AD is equal to 1.4 cm, AC is equal to 7.2 cm and AE is equal to 1.8 cm. So this is your homework problem. Then next we are going to see problem number 4. In figure, if P PQ is parallel to BC. So PQ BC இது ரெண்டும் parallelா இருக்கு. Similarly PR and CD both are parallel. You have to prove that the first subdivision is AR by AD. That is AR by AD is equal to AQ by AB. Then the second subdivision is QB by AQ is equal to DR by AR. So problem number 4 solution. This is the given figure. First we are taking a triangle ABC. So we can see we are taking this triangle ABC. In this PQ is parallel to CB is given in the question itself. By using basic proportionality theorem we can easily write that AQ by AB is equal to AP by PC. This is equation number 1. Next we are taking the triangle ACD. So lower triangle. Here also PR is parallel to CD. That is also given in the question. Again by using basic proportionality theorem we can write AP by AC is equal to AR by AD. This is equation number 2. So by using 1 and 2 we can write AQ by AP, AB is equal to AP by AC is equal to AR by AD. So we can have AR by AD is equal to AQ by AB. So hence we proved the first subdivision. Again the second subdivision from equation 1 and 2. So from equation 1 and 2 we can write AQ by AB is equal to AR by AD. So we just taking reciprocal, that is we are taking denominator as numerator and numerator as denominator. That is AB by AQ is equal to AD by AR. Then AB is nothing but AQ plus QB. So இப்ப நம்ம பார்த்தோம்னா AB எப்படி எழுதலாம்னா AQ plus QB அப்படின்னு எழுதலாம். So AQ plus QB divided by AQ which is equal to AD is nothing but AR plus RD by AR. Here we are separating the denominator, AQ, AQ get cancelled. So 1 plus QB by AQ which is equal to 1 plus RD by AR which is implies QB by AQ is equal to DR or RD by AR. Hence we proved the second solution also. Next one, problem number 5 in exercise 4.2. Rhombus PQRB is inscribed in a triangle ABC such that angle B is one of its angle. PQR lie on AB, AC and BC respectively. If AB is equal to 12 cm and BC is equal to 6 cm, then find the sides PQ, RB of the rhombus. So solution, in this we can see two triangles. First we are taking a triangle CRQ. Then another one triangle is CBA. So in this two triangle we can see angle CRQ. So angle CRQ is equal to angle CBA because RQ is parallel to AB. So இப்ப இந்த RQ உம் இந்த AB ரெண்டும் parallel-ஆ இருக்கு. So இந்த angle-உம் நமக்கு equal-ஆ இருக்கும். So similarly we can write CQR is equal to CAB because here also RQ and AB both are parallel. So therefore we conclude that triangle CRQ and triangle CBA is both are similar triangle. That is triangle CRQ is congruent to triangle CBA. So we can write CR by CB is equal to RQ by BA. So let the side of the rhombus be A. இப்போ side of the rhombus நம்ப ஏன் consider பண்ணிக்கிறோம். So CR is nothing but 6 minus A divided by CB is 6 which is equal to RQ is A divided by BA is 12 is given in the question. That is AB is 12 centimeters given in the question. Now the next step is cross multiplication. So 72 minus 12A is equal to 6A. So 18a is equal to 72. The value of a is equal to 4. Therefore, from that we conclude that the side of the rhombus PQRB, that is PQ and RB, is 4 cm and 4 cm respectively. So we can see the rhombus is PQ, R and B. That is the measurement of RB and PQ is 4 cm. Problem number 6. In trapezium ABCD, AB is parallel to DC. E and F are the points on non-parallel sides AD and BC respectively, such that EF is parallel to AB. Show that AE by ED is equal to BF by FC. Problem number 6. Solution. So this is the given trapezium ABCD. So first we have to join a line from the point A to C. The line meet EF at the point G. So now we can see two triangles. So first we are taking the upper triangle, that is in a triangle ADC we have seen that EG is parallel to DC. So by using Thales theorem we can write AE by ED is equal to AG by GC. Similarly, by using the Thales theorem for the lower triangle, we can write in a triangle ABC we have AG by GC is equal to BF by FC. So from equation 1 and 2 we can prove that AE by ED is equal to BF by FC. That's all. So same model, we can do the problem number 7 as your home assignment. Similarly, problem number 8 and 9 also your homework. So problem number 7 is in figure D is parallel to BC and CD is parallel to EF. You have to prove that AD square is equal to AB into AF. Then problem number 8 is in triangle ABC, AD is the bisector of angle A, meeting side BC at D. If AB is equal to 10 cm, AC is equal to 14 cm and BC is equal to 6 cm, you have to find the side of BD and DC. Then 9th problem is also your homework. So check whether AD is the bisector of angle A of a triangle ABC. In each of the following, the measurement is given. So the 3 problems is very simple. You just do it on your own. This 3 problem is your home assignment. Next problem number 10. In figure, angle QPR is equal to 90 degrees. PS is its bisector. If ST is perpendicular to PR, then prove that ST into PQ plus PR is equal to PQ into PR. Problem number 10. Solution. So this is the given figure. Given that PS, here PS is the bisector of angle P. So PS in the line da, the P in the angle renda bisect pannudhu of a triangle PQR. So by using angle bisector theorem we can write PQ by PR is equal to QS by SR. Then adding 1 on both sides. So PQ by PR plus 1 is equal to QS by SR plus 1. Then the next step is cross multiplication. So PQ plus PR by PR is equal to QS plus SR by SR. So PQ plus PR by PR is equal to QS plus SR. QS plus SR is nothing but QR. So QR divided by SR. This is your equation number 1. Next we are taking a triangle RST. So next that we are taking the triangle RST and triangle RQP. So RQP. So this triangle and the whole triangle. So we have seen that angle SRT is equal to angle QRP. Here angle R is common. Then QPR is equal to angle STR is equal to 90 degrees. So one angle is common and one angle is 90 degrees. So by using angle criteria we can show that triangle RST is similar to triangle RQP. So RS by RQ is equal to ST by QP. So QP by ST is equal to QR by RS. This is your equation number 2. So from 1 and 2, we can easily prove the result. So QP by ST is equal to PQ plus PR by PR. Then the next step is cross multiplication. So PQ into PR is equal to S to ST into PQ plus PR. Hence we proved. Next problem number 11. ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AB is equal to AD. The bisector of angle BAC and angle CAD intersect the sides BC and CD at the points E and F respectively. So prove that EF is parallel to BD. So problem number 11 solution. So this is the required quadrilateral ABCD. So given a quadrilateral ABCD in which AB is equal to AD. So AB AD rendu equal. And the bisector of angle BAC. So here we can see the bisector of angle BAC and CAD. Meet the sides BC and CD. So BC in the side liyum, CD in the side liyum, E and F in the point la meet agudhu. So adha namba dotted lines which join panona, we get a triangles. So now to prove EF is parallel to BD. So EF um BD um parallel ah irukku abindrada namba prove pananum. So construction is you have to join AC. So the next step is you have to join AC, then BD and EF. Proof in triangle CAB. First nama enna triangle choose panna porona CAB. So in the triangle nama choose pandrom idula AE indradha bisector of angle A. So first in the triangle mattum nama paathom appadina CAB in the triangle la AE indradhu angle bisector A va A indra angle renda bisect pannudhu. So in a triangle CAB, A is the bisector of angle BAC. So we can write AC divided by AB is equal to CE by BE. So this is your equation number 1. Similarly, in a triangle ACD. So ippa nama choose panna vendiya triangle vandu ACD. So idha vittittu in the triangle choose pandrom. So idhula nama paathona AF indradha nammaloada angle bisector. So in a triangle ACD, AF is the bisector of angle CAD. So similarly we can write AC by AD is equal to CF by TF. So AC by AD is nothing but AB. So AD yum AB yum rendum same abindrathu question le kuduttaanga. So namba inge AD ku badala AB substitute pandrom. So this is your equation number 2. So comparing equation 1 and 2 we can write, you can see in this left hand side both are equal, so we can equate the right hand side. So CE by BE is equal to CF by DF. So CE by EB is equal to CF by FD. So thus in a triangle CBD, E and F divide the sides CB and CD respectively in the same ratio. Therefore, by the converse of Thales theorem, we proved that EF is parallel to BD. So hence we proved. So that's all students. Up to this exercise 4.2 problems are over.